and 12. Hearken unto me, O Jacob, and Israel my called. I am he. I am the first. I also am the last. There it is again. And then from there go to Isaiah 52 and 6. And we're almost finished. 52 and 6. Therefore my people shall know my name. Therefore they shall know in that day that I am he that doth speak. Behold, it is I. And you could write in there Matthew 1 and 21. And that verse goes back to say, Matthew 1 and 21 says, and she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, and he shall save his people from their sins. Lesson concluded with this final understanding. This Jesus, he is the permanent flesh manifestation of the Creator. That flesh will never leave him. When he appeared in theophany form in the Old Testament, it was only temporary. An angel in the fire, a voice out of the burning bush, etc., as we've discussed. But when Jesus came, it was a fusion of omnipotence and deity with human frailty. And his name shall be called Immanuel, God with us in the flesh. The world had never had that before, never. I made a little drawing for you here tonight to sort of, it's my own little parabolic understanding, but a picture's worth a thousand words. I don't know how it is here in Singapore, but in America, I know how it is. I'm sure it's true here, I just haven't looked for it that much. But in the United States, all along the highways in the country and nearer cities, there will be highlines, electrical highlines running. And in certain areas, there will be a big sign that says, danger, high voltage. In other words, you don't go near that area because the voltage is very high. And what would happen is, if here's a house in the countryside, if they ran a wire directly from this high voltage into this house, it would blow the house up. So what they do is they set a pole outside in the yard, outside the house. They run the high voltage to this pole, but they hang a transformer on the pole, which reduces the voltage down so the reduced voltage can go into the house and they have electricity and the house is not blown up. If God had come into this world with his glorified body, he was high voltage, danger. People would have melted in his presence. The only place that nearly happened was in the Garden of Gethsemane when they cried out, who are you? And Jesus said, I am he. And it's just that his statement caused those soldiers to fall back like dead men on the ground. In other words, he pulled back that robe of flesh, and for just a flash, that glory came out when he said, I am he. So, Jesus, if he had come, as I said, we would have been disintegrated. But Jesus on a cross became our transformer. That power of God, that glory, that high voltage channeled through him, reduced the voltage so that we could touch him, look in his face, hear his words, see him. Jesus is our transformer. He made this possible for us to touch him. And when we shall see him, it doth not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that when we shall see him and be like him. Tremendous.